Le'olam va'ed, Baruch ata Adonai, Mikadesh HaShabbat.
Amen.
Sima Tov, Mazel Tov, Mazel Tov, Sima Tov, Sima Tov.
So we want to make it official that Parker has become a bar mitzvah here at Ramat Shalom, and we are very proud of your accomplishment. It really is so special to stand here with you with this Torah here and realize how much your family appreciates what you have done and how that you have allowed yourself to become part of this Torah and following in the footsteps of so many people in this Torah here. And if you think for just a moment, you know, this Torah dates back to the 1940s and people celebrating big things in your life. The Torah that you read from is about 175 years old. And if you think about the number of bar mitzvah kids that have stood in front of it, the number of people who have carried it over those 175 years, you're talking about thousands upon thousands of people. And you are now one of those people who have honored the Torah and have kept it moving forward. And we're just so happy that you have done this, because if there's ever a generation of Jews who stop doing this, well, we're in trouble as a people. So you fill us with hope, and you allow us to realize that for the next generation, things are good for all of us. It's my honor to present you with a Torah, your own Torah, that you'll be able to take with you, and as you get older, read through it. And in each of the kids' Torahs that they get, I pick a verse that I think teaches an important lesson to the kids. And the verse for you has to do with that sabbatical year that I talked about at the beginning of your Torah portion, where it says to an ancient farmer, you're allowed to sow your field for 6 years, and for 6 years you can prune your vineyard and gather in its produce, but on the seventh year, you have to let it all rest. And that's what the sabbatical year is all about. During the sabbatical year, the land gets a complete rest. So what do we learn from this? There are really three lessons that we learn from the idea of allowing the land to rest. In the same way that we are supposed to, every 7 days, every Saturday, every Sabbath, allow ourselves to rest. Because just like on Shabbat, when the week comes to an end and a new week is about to begin, the sabbatical year teaches us that rest is really important. We can't be productive people if we don't allow ourselves to rest. That's one of the most important concepts in Judaism. Now, the problem with that is, it might sound like we're lazy. Right? Rest all the time, hang out on the couch all the time, play the video games all the time. But rest comes only after, in the case of Shabbat, 6 days, or in the case of the sabbatical year, after 6 years of hard work. Rest is something that is really earned. And finally, the third lesson, in order to let the land rest for an entire year, every 7 years, one has to work really hard to prepare for that sabbatical year. Because if you don't prepare for the year, you don't have any food to eat. So you gotta work really hard so that your land doesn't have to grow for a year. So the lesson is that resting and relaxing requires a lot of hard work and a lot of preparation. The more you put into life, the more work that you do, the more beautiful the rest, the more important the relaxation. So if you take this lesson, which I know that you will, to heart, I know that it will just add to the multiple things that you have inside of you that will allow you to go and change the world and make it a better place, which you've already started to do And I can't wait to see you continue to that work of making the world better in only a way that you can. I want to present you with your Torah as we say hafokba, v'hafokba, dehuleba, turn it and turn it, because everything is in it. Mazel tov.
You did it, huh?
Yep.
You did it. You worked hard, kind of waited till the end.
Yeah.
You made everybody sweat a lot, especially your tutor, Miss Miriam, who kept coming to me and going, he's not studying. Like, don't worry, he's got this. He'll get it in the end, and he did. Good for you. I don't know if you do everything last minute like that, but you're going to give your folks a lot more gray hair if you don't start kind of stepping it up a little bit. But luckily, you're sharp enough to be able to pull it off even under the gun. And it's been a lot of fun working with you. And I think I only came here 2 years ago, and your brother, I think, was one of my, I think might have been my first, right? It was my very first bar mitzvah here at Ramat Shalom. And so you are the first opportunity that I've had to do a sibling in the same family. And it's really special because I get to see your family. And I remember them all from 2 years ago. And it's really wonderful. And I hope that we'll get to share a lot, many more simchas with your family in the years to come and have all of you come here and join us. You know, like when you get married in a couple years, right? No, just kidding. No, he's going to wait on that too. Don't worry. But anyway, and I also want to thank you because your family's been really helpful to my family, because when I took the job, I also put my son in your school.
Yeah.
And your mom gave me lots of advice that you gave me, and your brother have been helping us out. And my son's been really entrenched in your school, and you guys see each other there and kind of buds, and that's special too. So again, look forward to a lot more accomplishments from you in the years to come from your brother. And I want to offer you this. This is a gift card. Do you know where it's to?
Where?
You don't know?
Can I open it?
Go ahead. Tell everybody.
Menchie's?
Menchie's.
Oh.
Menchie's. So what we do here at Ramat Shalom is after the kids become bar and bat mitzvah, we entice them to keep coming around because we like them and we want them to hang out with us until they go off into new ventures, maybe when they go away to college or whatever they decide to do. So we give them a free gift card to Menchie's. We take you guys out for ice cream or yogurt, and we put the first one on us. So I hope that you will take us up on that, and that we'll see a lot more of you and your brother in the years to come. And I wish you and your family a huge mazel tov.
Thank you, Cantor.
So we talked about this Torah being 175 years old. I want to present you now with a Torah much older. That's our largest Torah in the yard. It's about 350 years old. And it survived, the survivor of the Holocaust. It comes from Poland, Czechoslovakia, and in May of 1942, early June of 1942, the Nazis swept into that town and took the Jews. And the Torah was left at the center of the community all by itself and left alone. But it made it here miraculously in the 1980s. And in fact, the Kashi family is here with us today, and they were instrumental in making certain that this Torah made it here, and it now lies at the heart of our community. And today, as you walk around with this scroll, this 350-year-old Torah scroll, it's a beautiful image of our most recent bar mitzvah carrying our incredibly difficult past forward, but with strength and with love and dedication. We ask if you can to rise with us. Thank you.